Hi, my name is Andre and today I'm showing you how to works with Advanced Culling System. Advanced Culling System, it's a bundle of tools for optimizing your games. The main idea is hiding objects that not visible by the camera. For example, these objects may be overlapped by one large object or by many small objects. In the description, you can find links on videos demonstrating how this tool works. For example, comparisons of Occlusion Culling and Advanced Culling System. I will tell you about working with all modules of this system. Chunks Master, Static Culling, Dynamic Culling. Let's start. First of all, you need to prepare your project. The Advanced Culling System works with new Unity features, such as the C# Job System and Burst Compiler. You need to open the Package Manager and download these packages. Burst Compiler, Collections, Mathematics. Enable Burst Compile. The last thing you need to do is make sure you have an empty slot for the layers in Tag Manager. When the tool started, a new layer will be added there. Done. You can now import the Advanced Culling System. If the least a small part of the object gets into the camera view, then the whole object will be rendered. If you have a very large object on the scene, it is sometimes useful to split this object into small ones. You need to go to the tab Advanced Culling System Chunks Master. Use these buttons to add objects into Chunks Master. In this field, you specify the path where the created meshes will be stored. Chunks Master automatically split objects into small pieces. In this field, you specify how to max triangles count will contain in a single piece. To preview how your objects will be split, click Show Created Chunks. If you change the value of max triangles, you need to press Apply to preview changes. Once you have configured all parameters, click the Split button. Be careful. Chunks Master should only be used on objects with a large number of polygons. To see at the visual difference in work before and after applying Chunks Master, use the Frustum Culling Visualization script. Use this script only to view the changes. Frustum Culling Visualization does not affect performance. This tool only works with static objects. To start this tool, you need to go to the Advanced Culling System Static Culling tab. In this tab, you can set cameras there or do it later with Static Culling API. In this tab, you must set the objects to be culled. Attention, you can't add any objects in runtime to this list. In this tab, you need to set areas where your cameras will be located. This can be set automatically or manually. The smaller the area, the less time it takes to bake. These values represent the accuracy of scene computing. Greater value takes more time for baking. If you use the fast bake option, the scene will bake faster, but the visibility of objects will be calculated less accuracy. In some cases, it is possible that the object that should be visible will be hidden. Every time your camera moves to a new cell, visible objects will be updated. To call static culling methods, use the static property static culling.instance in namespace advanced culling system.static culling core. You can call these methods: disable, to disable static culling; enable, to activate static culling; add camera, to add a new camera in the list; and remove camera, to delete the camera from the list. This tool only works with dynamic objects. To start this tool, you need to go to the Advanced Culling System Dynamic Culling tab. Setting up dynamic culling is very simple. You can set cameras there, or do it later with Dynamic Culling API. A job's per frame value sets how accurately the visibility of objects will be computed in every frame. If this value is too small, situations may happen when the object that should be visible at the moment is hidden. At the same time, a too high value can lead to a drop in FPS. A value of object's lifetime sets how long invisible objects will be rendered. I do not recommend setting this value lower than 1.5. Here you need to add which objects should be culled. You can specify them now, or add them later via scripts. For example, if they instanced during the gameplay. As with static culling, to call dynamic culling methods, use the dynamic culling.instance in namespace advanced culling system.dynamic culling core static property. You can use these methods, enable, disable, add camera, remove camera, add object for culling, remove object for culling, set jobs per frame count, set objects lifetime. Let's see at the interaction with dynamic culling API for example. I have a script that instantiates new objects in random positions. To cull the instanced object, you need to add this object to dynamic culling. I hope I teach you how to work with the advanced culling system. If you have any questions, you can freely contact me at any time by email, the link will be in the description. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day.